हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू दिस लेसन ऑफ राइटिंग एंड सेलिंग योर फर्स्ट फिल्म स्क्रिप्ट। सो इन द लास्ट लेसन वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट हाउ टू राइट द वन लाइनर ऑफ द फिल्म, द फर्स्ट स्टेप, द वन लाइनर और द लॉग लाइन ऑफ द फिल्म। ओके, नाउ इन दिस लेसन वी लर्न अबाउट हाउ टू राइट द वी लर्न अबाउट द सेकेंड स्टेप, विच इज हाउ टू राइट द सिनॉप्सिस। ओके, सो वॉट इज सिनॉप्सिस? ओके, सो once you have written the idea of the film, the next step is to write the synopsis of the film. It is also known as the one pager of the film. Okay, so what is synopsis? Now think of synopsis as the trailer of any film. Okay, so you go to the theater and we see the trailer on the screen. Okay, so think of the synopsis as the trailer of your film. So synopsis is a trailer of your script. Okay, so synopsis is basically expanding the one-liner that you have written in the first step. Okay, so it is the expanded one-liner. Now one-liner is written in one or two lines. Okay, so script writing synopsis is basically expanding that one or two lines into further 5 to 10 lines. Okay, so let us see how to write a synopsis. Okay, so basically synopsis, we'll see how to write the synopsis. Okay, now again I'm telling you, synopsis you can consider as it is the trailer of any film. Okay, so synopsis is written in 5 to 10 lines, basically one page. Okay, so it is also written in present tense and as a third person. Okay, so you have to write synopsis as if you're telling the story to somebody about the film. Okay, so that is the synopsis. You are telling it as a third person and write it in present tense. Okay, now synopsis is a very short core story of the film, again like a trailer. Okay, it is not a very expanded story of the film, it is a short core story of the film. Okay, it gives enough idea in order to generate interest and curiosity. Okay, so when you basically pitch your film or send your script to anybody, the first thing they will read is the log line. Now if they like the log line or the one liner, they will go into reading the synopsis of the film. Okay, so this is very important that you write a very interesting synopsis. So your synopsis should give enough idea in order to generate interest and curiosity, and if they like the synopsis, they will see the script and read the script. Okay, because these people, the producers and the studio houses, they get lot of scripts daily, and it's really impossible to read so many scripts every time. So if the script reader, they will like the logline and the synopsis, then only they will go further and read the main script of the film. Okay, so it is very important that you write a very very interesting synopsis. Okay, then the next point is, it should persuade the reader to read or see the complete script of film. Okay, so basically your synopsis, it should persuade the reader to read the complete script. Okay, then next point is, avoid giving too much information in the synopsis. Okay, so synopsis, as I have told you before, that it is like a trailer of the film. It should just create some curiosity, more curiosity. Okay, so avoid giving too much information. Then next is, avoid revealing too many twists and turns. Don't reveal too many twists and turns, and never reveal the ending of the film or the script in the synopsis. Okay, keep the ending a suspense in the synopsis. Okay, so these are few points that you should keep in mind while writing your synopsis of the film or expanding the logline into a synopsis. Okay, we'll see some example of how to write the synopsis. Now there is this film called Slumdog Millionaire. Okay, it is an Oscar winning film, and it was shot in India. So let's see the logline first. The logline of the film, the logline is, a Mumbai teenager reflects on his life after being accused of cheating on the Indian version of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. This is the logline of the film. This contains the protagonist, this contains the antagonist, this contains the action, the goal, and the stake. Okay, now let us see the synopsis, how we have expanded this logline into a one pager, okay, into a synopsis. So the synopsis is, Slumdog Millionaire is the story of Jamal Malik, an 18-year-old orphan from the slums of Mumbai, who is about to experience the biggest day of his life. With the whole nation watching, he is just one question away from winning a staggering 20 million rupees on India's first Who Want to Be a Millionaire. But when the show breaks for the night, the police arrest him on suspicion of cheating. How could a street kid know so much? Desperate to prove his innocence, Jamal tells the story of his life in the slum where he and his brother grew up, on their adventure towards on the road, of vicious encounters with local gangs, and of Latika, a girl he loved and lost. Each chapter of his story reveals the key to the answer to one of the game show's first question. Each chapter of Jamal's increasingly layered story reveals where he learned the answers of the show's seemingly impossible quizzes. But one question remains a mystery. What is this young man with no apparent desire for riches really doing on this game show? When the new day dawns and Jamal returns to answer the question, the final question, the inspector and the 60 million viewers are about to find out. So this is the synopsis of the film. Now you have seen how we have expanded each component that we used in writing a log line. Okay, we have expanded we have expanded the protagonist. Okay, then we have expanded the action, then we have expanded the antagonist, then we have expanded the goal, and we have expanded the stake. What is at stake? Okay, so in the synopsis, this is the synopsis. This is the synopsis that we have written, and we have expanded each component of a logline into further more detailed storyline. Okay, so this is like a trailer of the film. Okay, so in the first three lines, we have established the hero of the film and the environment of the film. Then we have established the conflict of the film, and then we have question the ending of the film. So in synopsis, never reveal the ending, but a way of writing the synopsis is, don't reveal the ending, but ask a question to the reader that what will happen in the end. So for example, we have written here, but one question remains a mystery. What is this young man with no apparent desire for riches really doing on the game show? So the ending we have asked as a question in the synopsis. Okay, and then we end the synopsis when the solution is resolved, when we get the solution, how after the solution of the main conflict, the whole environment changes. Okay, so this is how synopsis is written. We'll see another example of synopsis. It is called Three Idiots. Now Three Idiots is again an Indian Bollywood film. Okay, first we have taken examples of in the logline we have taken examples of the Hollywood films. Now in synopsis we are taking examples of the Bollywood films. So Three Idiots, okay, so this is a very famous Indian film, a Bollywood film. So let us first see the logline. So the logline is, two friends searching for their long lost companion revisit their college days and recall the memories of their friends who inspired them to think differently, even as the rest of the world called them idiots. Okay, so this is the logline of the film. Okay, this contains the protagonist, the antagonist. The antagonist is the world. The protagonist the protagonist is a long lost companion. Okay, so then the action is two friends searching. Okay, revisit their old days. Then the antagonist, and then the main goal. Okay, so we have expanded this logline in synopsis. Now let us see the synopsis. So two friends embark on a quest for a lost buddy. On this journey, they encounter a long forgotten bet, a wedding they must crash, and a funeral that goes ridiculously out of control. As they make their way through the perilous landscape, another journey begins. Their inner journey through memory lane and the story of their friend, the impressible freethinker Rancho, who is in unique way touched and changed their lives. It's the story of their hostel days that swings between Rancho's romance with the spirited Pia and his clash with an oppressive mentor, Viru Sahasrabuddha. And then one day, suddenly, Rancho vanished. Who was he? Where did he come from? Why did he leave? The friend who influenced and inspired them to think creatively and independently, even as the conformist world called them three idiots. Where is the original idiot now? Finally, in the mist mountains of unparalleled beauty, the friends find the key to secret. So we have written the synopsis also. Okay. So the ending, where is the original idiot now? Okay. The main goal, the main ending of the film. Okay. So that has been asked as a question. So I've told you that when you write a synopsis, you write the ending as a question. Okay. And then we have expanded the each component, like the friends, the protagonist, the antagonist, the action, the stake. Okay, we have all expanded in few lines and written it here in the form of one pager or synopsis. Okay, so this is how you write the synopsis of the film. So the first step is to write the log line of the film or the one liner of the film. Okay, so the idea that you have in your mind, you write that in the form of one liner first on a piece of paper by using the formula that I have told you. Okay, so that is the formula that you will use to write the one liner. Now, once you write the one liner, things have become a bit clear in your mind. Okay, that you want to make a film, write a script on this topic. Okay, you know your protagonist, you know your antagonist, you know the action you want to take in one line, you know the goal that is achieved in the film, and you know what is at stake. So as a reader also, the person will know that what is the whole film is all about. Okay, and then once you write the log liner or the one liner of the film, the log line or the one line of the next step is to expand each component of one line a bit further and write the one pager or the short story of the film, which you can consider as a trailer of the film. Okay, so we have learned how to write the synopsis of the film, okay, in the form of one page. Okay, now let us read this quote. Amateurs sit and wait for inspiration, the rest of us just get up and go to work. It is said by Stephen King. Now, why I have mentioned this quote here is because a lot of script writers and a lot of us, we think that we wait for the right moment to write the script and write inspiration. But what I am suggesting is you will only get better in writing the script by actually writing it and by making mistakes. So I suggest that you start writing daily, whatever you want to write, start writing daily. Okay, one page, five lines, one line, or even two page, three page, whatever you want to write, but write daily. Okay, so by writing only, you will only make mistakes and you will realize how to correct it. And all the things that we have learned till now, it will start making sense to you. Okay, so in this lesson, whatever you will learn, it will start making sense to you. Okay. Once you start writing it yourself, because nothing can teach you than writing it yourself. So it is very important that you make a habit of writing every day something about something. Okay, and be consistent about it. So don't just wait that one day I learn and then I will start writing. Okay, by writing only you learn, and by doing mistakes only you learn. Okay.